الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، حبت في الله إمام فوزان حفظ الله تعالى. He then goes on to mention the third benefit of seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, from the benefits of seeking forgiveness is that it is a means of driving away worries, bringing sustenance, and having a way out from difficulties. And in the Sunan of Abi Dawood and Ibn Majah, it was reported by Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, who said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever holds fast to seeking forgiveness, Allah will make a way out for him from every difficulty and a relief from every grief, and he will provide for him from where he does not expect. Ahabati fillah, under the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Under. Look at this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Reflect on this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not from the saints, not from the righteous, not from one another, but the tawbah, the repentance, and the istighfar min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and you. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. So, Imam Fawzani said, from the benefits of seeking forgiveness, that it's a means. It drives away worries. So that's a way to cut down on your stress, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. It's also a way of getting your rizq increased and getting you out of difficulties. That's three immense benefits. Cutting down stress. We all need to cut down the stress. Many of us, most of us, can use an increase in our wealth and our rizq and our sustenance. And most of us can surely benefit from a way out from the various trials and tribulations and difficulties and struggles that we face. So seek forgiveness. Istighfar. Kathrata istighfar from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. Say it with certainty. Say it with meaning. Say it with purpose. Say it with sincerity. And strive to leave off those sins that are preventing you from the good and that are causing the stress and strife in your life. Wallahu musta'an. The fourth benefit Imam Fawzan mentioned, and he said, and from the benefits of seeking forgiveness is that it is a cause for the sending down of rain and increase of wealth and children and vegetation of the trees and providing of water. Allah said regarding his prophet Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, I said to them, ask forgiveness from your Lord. Verily, he is all forgiving. He will send rain to you in abundance and give you increase in wealth and children and bestow on you gardens and bestow on you rivers. And he said regarding Hud, alayhi salatu wasalam, and O my people, ask forgiveness from your Lord and then repent to him. He will send you from the sky abundant rain and add strength to your strength. Servants of Allah, seeking forgiveness is a legislated matter for all times. And there are certain times and conditions in which seeking forgiveness is more virtuous. So it is more recommended to seek forgiveness after performing acts of worship, because it will be an expiation for what occurs from shortcomings and deficiencies in the worship. Meaning, after salat, make istighfar. Astaghfirullah. 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 And all the other legislated ways of dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after salat. But making istighfar at that point is seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the shortcomings in that act of ibadah, in your prayer. And then he says, because it will be an expiation for what occurs from shortcomings and deficiencies in worship, just as it was legislated to do so after completing the five obligatory prayers. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to seek forgiveness three times after making the taslim of the obligatory prayer. This is because a servant is likely to have deficiencies in his prayer due to the heedlessness and forgiveness, because we're distracted by the dunya, we're distracted and we become forgetful and we become heedless and we become busy and we become engaged in other activities when we should be focusing on our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worshiping him tabaraka wa ta'ala alone during the prayer. It is also legislated to seek forgiveness when completing the night prayer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says regarding the people of taqwa. That means this is a sifa of the people of taqwa. The people, the muttaqun, the muttaqeen. Those people, one of their characteristics is that they seek istighfar, and they seek istighfar after the night prayer, meaning that they're doing the night prayer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they used to sleep but little by night, invoking their Lord and praying with fear and hope, and in the hours before dawn, and they were found asking Allah for forgiveness. And Allah says, and those who seek forgiveness during the last part of the night. So, ahabati fillah, it shows us how important it is, istighfar. And there's so many, many benefits, as we'll get to some of the others shortly, bi'idhnillah ta'ala, or the last part of what Imam Fawzan has to say regarding this important topic. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.